let us discuss questions on chemistry of lipids. Unlike carbohydrate and proteins, which are defined chemically, lipids are defined by their physical property. Okay, they are water insoluble. That is their main property. Okay, lipids are chemically diverse. Okay, carbohydrate, the definition is polyhydroxyaldehydes or polyhydroxyketones or compounds which produce them on hydrolysis. Okay, amino acid, they will contain amino group and a carboxylic group. But lipids, we cannot tell them chemically. Okay, they are defined physical property. Okay, defined by their physical property, whether they are water soluble or insoluble. Okay, all the lipids are water insoluble. Okay, which of the following is a derived lipid? For this, you should know the classification of lipids given in your Harper: simple, complex, and derived lipid. Derived lipid is also known as precursor lipids. See, when you hydrolyze triglyceride, you get fatty acids and glycerol. Okay, so this glycerol and fatty acids are considered as derived lipid or precursor lipid, because glycerol and fatty acids, they can produce triglyceride, right? So they are precursors in one sense. In other sense, they are derived lipids because they are derived from triglycerides. Okay, that is why the answer is fatty acid. Okay, what about this glycolipid? Glycolipid is your complex lipid, phospholipid, glycolipid and sulfolipid. They are all complex lipid. Okay, triglycerides are your simple lipid. Okay, don't think that fatty acids are the simple lipid. Okay, triglycerides are your simple lipid, and on hydrolysis they will produce fatty acids which are derived or precursor lipid. Okay, so as this is given in Harper, they can ask you simply this question: free fatty acids in blood are carried by. Free fatty acids are not free. Okay, the free here indicates that they are non-esterified. Okay, NEFA, non-esterified fatty acids. Okay, esterified fatty acids are those which are esterified with glycerol, triglycerides, okay, or some other compound. Non-esterified fatty acids have to be carried by something, right? That is your albumin. Okay, hydrophobic cleft in the albumin carries free fatty acids. Okay, which of the following is a branched chain fatty acid? This you should know. There are certain fatty acids which are branched. That is your phytanic acid. This is present in algae. Okay, so the fish which eats algae, that will also contain phytanic acid, right? Phytanic acid is a branched chain fatty acid. We will encounter this again in the upcoming questions. Arachidonic acid has 20 carbon atoms. Okay, now they are asking how many double bonds. Okay, so here you should know the fatty acids can be either saturated or unsaturated. Unsaturated can be monounsaturated and polyunsaturated, that is PUFA. Monounsaturated means just one double bond. What is the meaning of saturated? Saturated means all the carbons are saturated with hydrogen. That is called saturation. Okay, unsaturation means hydrogen is not there. In place of hydrogen, you have another bond. That is your double bond. Okay, one bond means two electrons. Okay, so monounsaturated means single double bond. Polyunsaturated means more than one double bond. So obviously, arachidonic acid is a PUFA, polyunsaturated fatty acid. The question is how many double bonds? This table given in Harper is very, very important. Okay, so here they are giving all the fatty acids which are very, very important. See this palmitoleic acid. Okay, palmitoleic acid, you are having one double bond. Okay, 16 means 16 carbon, one double bond, and the position is 9. Okay, at the 9th carbon. Okay, So this, there is a omega numbering. Omega numbering is from this side, opposite to the COOH, from the methyl side. So you can see that 16, then double bond is the 9. So 16 minus 9, that means it is omega 7. Okay. Oleic acid is a mono unsaturated fatty acid. Again, 18, 9. So 18 minus 9, it is omega 9. Okay. Elidic acid is a trans fatty acid. It is same as of oleic acid, and it is a double bond is trans double bond. Okay. Dienoic acid, linoleic acid. Linoleic acid is a 18 carbon fatty acid with two double bond, positions 9 and 12. So 18 minus 12, it will be omega 6. Very simple. It's a omega 6 polyunsaturated fatty acids. If there is more than one double bond, it means polyunsaturated fatty acids. Three double bonds. See this, alpha linolenic acid. Okay, linolenic acid. This is not linoleic. Linolenic acid. There is another N. So there is one more double bond. Remember like this. The name is lengthy. So there is more double bond. Okay. There is another double bond at 15th position. So 9, 12, 15. There are three double bond. 18 carbon. So 18 minus 15 will be omega 3. Okay. This is again very important. Omega 3 fatty acid. Gamma linolenic acid is omega 6 fatty acid. It is not a omega 3 fatty acid. Okay. Tetraenoic acid, 4 double bond. That is your arachidonic acid. Okay. 20 carbon. Double bonds are at 5, 8, 11, 14. These double bonds are always separated between 3 carbon. So 5, if you start, it will be 8. And obviously, it will be 11. Then obviously, it will be 14. So 20 minus 14, it will be 6. Arachidonic acid is a omega 6 fatty acid. Fatty acid with 5 double bond is your thymidonic acid. 6 double bond, servonic acid. Okay. Eicoso. Eicosa, that means 20 carbon. That's why eicosanoids. Carbons, compounds having 20 carbon compounds. Okay. See here, these are all omega 3 fatty acid. Very, very important. What are the 3 omega 3 fatty acids? Alpha linolenic acid, thymidonic acid, otherwise your eicosopentaenoic acid, servonic acid, also known as docosahexaenoic acid, that is your DHA, this is your EPA. Okay, these are the 3 omega 3 fatty acid. Okay, what was the question? How many double bonds are there in the arachidonic acid? Answer will be 4 double bonds. Simple, right? Now, all of the following are omega 3 fatty acids except we have seen that gamma linolenic acid is omega 6. Okay, only these 3 are omega 3 fatty acids. Omega 3 fatty acids are cardioprotective. Okay, they prevent atherosclerosis. How? They produce type 3 prostanoids. They produce type 3 prostanoids. For example, they produce thromboxane, A3, prostaglandin, I3. Platelet aggregation capacity of this thromboxane A3 is weak. Vasodilating capacity of PGI3 is high. Or inhibiting the platelet aggregation capacity of PGI3 is high. So now what is happening? The overall effect is inhibition of platelet aggregation. Okay, that is why omega 3 fatty acids are cardioprotective, because they are producing type 3 prostanoids. Okay, so the answer will be gamma linolenic acid, which is a omega 6 fatty acid. Okay, which of the following fatty acid is present exclusively in breast milk? Okay, so that is why we say that exclusive breastfeeding is very important for the brain growth of child. So in TV advertisement, you might have seen, okay, docosahexaenoic acid, DHA. In advertisement, they will say, our this substitutes, it contains DHA, which is important for the brain growth. Okay, so DHA is present in the breast milk. Okay, clear? Snake venom contains, there are so many toxins in the snake venom. Out of them, there are phospholipases. which phospholipase is there? It contains phospholipase A2. Okay. This phospholipase A2, it produces lysolecithin. Okay. Lysophospholipid. Lecithin is a phospholipid, right? So it can produce lysolecithin. And this is very important in the bleeding manifestation. Okay. The downstream pathway I am not showing you. Okay. Ultimately, it will produce bleeding manifestation, hemorrhage. Okay. This is very important question for your national board. Make venum contain phospholipase A2. Okay. Phospholipids contain. Phospholipids are compound lipids. Okay. They will contain a phosphoryl group. Okay. Phospholipids can be of two types. Glycerophospholipid or sphingophospholipid. Okay. There is only one sphingophospholipid, that is your sphingomyelin. Okay. Sphingomyelin is the only sphingophospholipid. All other sphingolipids, they do not contain phosphoryl group. Okay. Glycerophospholipids. Okay. This we will see in the further questions. Now, let us see this options. Hydrophilic heads and hydrophobic tails. Okay. Let us see this image. See this. This is the tail. Okay. This tail is hydrophobic. This is a head which is hydrophilic because this head is containing the phosphate group. Okay. Option B. These are all long water soluble carbon chain. See, they are amphipathic molecule. Okay. So, because of amphipathic, we can say they are amphipathic. We cannot say it is long water soluble carbon chain. Okay. And if you see this head, okay, see the charge, negatively charged. But here it is saying it is positively charged functional group. Okay. So it is not positively charged functional group. Okay. So the answer will be this only, hydrophilic heads and hydrophobic tails, because this is amphipathic. Okay. Water soluble portion is just a head, it is small. Okay. The hydrophobic tail is very long. And it is negatively charged. Okay. It is not only positively charged. Okay. Which of the following phospholipid is predominantly bound in the inner mitochondrial membrane? Okay. So, if you see this, the membrane contains different kind of lipids. If you see the plasma membrane, you can see that cholesterol is more. Okay. You see the inner mitochondrial membrane. See this inner mitochondrial membrane. Can see that there is significant amount of cardiolipin. In lysosomal membrane, you see lot of sphingolipids. Okay. This differential distribution is according to the function. Cardiolipin is involved in the signaling pathways and all. For the complex 5, cardiolipin is important. Okay. That is why cardiolipin is found predominantly in the inner mitochondrial membrane. It is also present in other membrane, but it is in a very, very less amount. The defect in cardiolipin synthesis leads to which syndrome? Barth syndrome. Okay. Remember this. Barth syndrome is due to defect in cardiolipin synthesis. Okay. Anti-cardiolipin antibodies. You see these antibodies in many autoimmune diseases, right? Okay. So, answer is cardiolipin. Cervonic acid is present in. What is cervonic acid? It is a polyunsaturated fatty acid and it is also a omega 3 fatty acid. We have already seen this. Now, see this Harper table. Here they are saying which is cervonic acid. Cervonic acid is your docosahexaenoic acid. Okay. You have seen that it is present in breast milk, but it is also present in fish oil, algal oil and phospholipids in brine. Okay. So, the answer is fish oil. Okay, that is why they advertise fish oils. It contains DHA, brain growth, all these things. Okay. For infant, the exclusive source of DHA is breast milk. Infant, we cannot give fish oil. Okay, we give for the 6 months exclusive breastfeeding. Okay. Which of the following lipids is responsible for stimulation of hypersensitivity, activation of clotting, all these things? Okay, this is again very important question. The answer is platelet activating factor, PAF. Okay, this is a ether lipid. Okay, it contains a ether bond. Okay, like plasmalogen, platelet activating factor also contains a ether bond. Now, we have to know the concept of essential fatty acids. Essential fatty acids are those which cannot be synthesized in the human body. So, they need to be taken in the diet. Linoleic acid and linolenic acid, they cannot be synthesized in the body. Okay. They have to be taken in the diet. What about arachidonic acid? Initially, they considered this as essential fatty acid, but it is not so, because arachidonic acid can be synthesized in the body from linoleic acid. Okay, see this. From linoleic acid, we can produce arachidonic acid. Okay, so arachidonic acid is not an essential fatty acid, while linoleic and linolenic acid are essential fatty acid. Deficiency of essential fatty acids produce trichinoderma. Okay, dermatological manifestations. Rhino means toad. It's a toad skin. Okay. Alpha linolenic acid. Okay. During this synthesis, gamma linolenic acid is produced. Okay. So arachidonic acid is synthesized from alpha linolenic acid. But during that synthesis pathway, you can clearly see that there is gamma linolenic acid is also coming. It is not a omega 3 fatty acid. Okay. Alpha linolenic acid is a omega 3 fatty acid. Remember this also. All of the following are saturated fatty acids. That means these are the fatty acids without a double bond. Now see which fatty acids contain a double bond. Palmitic acid, 16 carbon, no double bond. Stearic acid, 18 carbon, no double bond. What about oleic acid? See this. Oleic acid, it contains a double bond. Okay. Oleic acid is unsaturated fatty acid. See this. Lauric is saturated 12 carbon, myristic 14 carbon saturated, palmitic 16 carbon, stearic 18 carbon. Okay. So remember like this. It is in the alphabetical order, right? L, M, P, S. Lauric, myristic, palmitic, stearic. 12, 14, 16, 18. Okay. Unsaturated fatty acids are oleic, linoleic, alpha linolenic, gamma linolenic, and all other arachidonic, EPA, DHA, all these things. Clear? So the answer is oleic acid, which is a unsaturated fatty acid. Next question, which of the following phospholipid is associated with apoptosis? We have already seen that phosphatidylserine is present only in the inner leaflet of the plasma membrane. Flipping of phosphatidylserine will lead to apoptosis. Okay. See this. Apoptosis. Here annexin, annexin 5, it will come and bind to this calcium and phosphatidylserine residues. Okay. So this annexin 5 is a marker of apoptosis. Okay. Flipping of phosphatidylserine to the outer leaflet leads to apoptosis. Remember this. So, another question, annexin 5 is a marker of, the answer will be apoptosis. Okay. All of the following are true about sphingolipids except. What are sphingolipids? Here, instead of glycerol, the alcohol is sphingosine. Sphingosine is an 18 carbon containing amino alcohol. In glycerol, there is just 3 carbon, right? But in sphingosine, you have 18 carbon and there is one amino group and there is 2 alcohol group. Remember this, there are 2 alcohol groups. Okay. And I have already told you that sphingomyelin is the only phospholipid. Okay, sphingophospholipid. So the answer is correct. Sphingomyelin is a phospholipid, correct answer. Sphingosine is an 18 carbon amino alcohol, correct answer only. Okay. Amphipathic in nature. Yes. All the phospholipids, they are amphipathic in nature. Okay. Sphingolipid is an amphipathic lipid. What about this option B? let me show you this. Here there is a two tail, right? The one tail is formed by fatty acid, the other tail is formed by the sphingosine itself because it is very long, 18 carbon compound. Okay, the one tail is formed by fatty acid and the other tail is formed by sphingosine. The R group will determine what sphingolipid it is. If the R group is phosphorylcholine, it is your, what is that? Sphingomyelin. Very good. Okay, sphingomyelin is the only sphingophospholipid. If the R group is some glucose or galactose, that will become your cerebroside. Okay, and this sphingosine plus fatty acid, and the fatty acids are now to the amino group, that is your ceramide. Okay, see this, this is your ceramide. What you are seeing is fatty acid binding to the amino group, so there is amide bond. This is ceramide. This is very, very important question. Ceramide is sphingosine plus fatty acid. Ceramide plus phosphorylcholine. The R group is phosphorylcholine. That is your sphingomyelin. Ceramide plus galactose. That will be your galactocerebroside. Galactocerebrosides are not phospholipids. There is no phosphoryl group here. Clear? Now let us come to the question. In the question, they are saying that two hydrocarbon tails are formed by fatty acid. That is wrong. Okay. One hydrocarbon tail is fatty acid. The other hydrocarbon tail is formed by the sphingosine itself. Okay. Defect in which of the following lipid is associated with Barth syndrome? I told you, cardiolipin. But here there is no cardiolipin. This is how they confuse you. What is the other name of cardiolipin? See, diphosphatidyl. These are all, that is your cardiolipin. Okay, so you have to be careful. You should know what is cardiolipin also. What is carnitine? Tell me, what is carnitine? It is involved in the transport of long chain fatty acids to the mitochondria for beta oxidation. What is that? That is beta hydroxy gamma trimethyl ammonium butyrate. Okay, sometimes they can ask you weird question like this. Beta hydroxy gamma trimethyl ammonium butyrate is carnitine. What is glutathione? This you should know. Glutathione is gamma glutamyl cysteinyl glycine. Okay, there is no excuse. You should know what is glutathione. Gamma glutamyl cysteinyl glycine. Okay, so cardiolipin is diphosphatidyl glycerol. All of the following are phospholipid except cardiolipin is what? Just now we have seen diphosphatidyl glycerol, it is a phospholipid. Sphingomyelin, I have told you so many times, it is the only sphingophospholipid. Surfactant lipid, what are the surfactant lipid? Dipalmitoyl lecithin. What is lecithin? Lecithin is phosphatidyl choline. So there is a phosphate there. What is cerebroside? Cerebrosides, there is a sugar group, there is no phospho group. See this? In cerebrosides, you have sugar units. It can be a glucocerebroside or galactocerebroside. Okay. All of the following are phospholipid except the answer will be cerebroside. Which of the following lipid does not contain glycerol? Okay. Triglyceride is a simple lipid containing glycerol. Okay. And I told you that there are two types of phospholipid, glycerophospholipid, sphingophospholipid. See this? Sphingomyelin is a sphingophospholipid. Cardiolipin, diphosphatidyl glycerol. So it is glycerophospholipid. Lecithin is phosphatidyl choline. Okay, again a glycerophospholipid. Okay, sphingomyelin is a sphingolipid. Respiratory distress syndrome is due to deficiency of which of the following? So here they are asking you that which of the following is a surfactant, lung surfactant? I told you dipalmitoyl lecithin is the lung surfactant. They line the alveolar membrane and normally they prevent the collapse of alveoli during expiration. So dipalmitoyl lecithin is a surfactant lipid. Surfactant is made up of both lipids and protein. Okay, there are certain surfactant proteins also. The major lipid component is dipolmethyl lecithin. Okay. All of the following are isoprene derivatives except. Isoprene is a 5-carbon compound. In our body, we have lot of isoprene derivatives. Okay. For example, cholesterol. That is an isoprene derivative. And all the fat soluble vitamins, they are isoprene derivative. And there is ubiquinone, coenzyme Q or Q10. It is named Q10 because it contains 10 isoprene derivatives. Okay, 10 isoprene rings. So ubiquinone is isoprene derivative. Dolichol, I told you all the fat soluble vitamins, they are all isoprene derivative. So the answer will be ubiquitine. Ubiquitine is a protein. It is not a lipid at all. Don't confuse ubiquitin with ubiquinone. Ubiquitin is involved in the proteasomal mediated destruction of proteins. Okay, ubiquitin itself is a protein. Which of the following is true about cholesterol? Amphipathic nature, it's true. Okay, directly I have seen the correct answer. Let's see the other options also. Made up of 25 carbons? No, it is made up of 27 carbon. There is a hydroxyl group at the 5th carbon. No, the hydroxyl group is present in the 3rd carbon. Okay. Contains cyclic tetraperhydrophenandrene ring. The ring present is CPP ring. Okay, cyclic pentanoperhydrophenandrene ring. Okay. It is not tetra. Okay. So it is wrong. So the correct answer is amphipathic in nature. Clear? It's pentanoperhydro. Okay, tetra is wrong. Which of the following is a phytosterol? You may be aware that cytosterol is a phytosterol. Cholesterol is a zoosterol. It is present only in animals. So, if someone is saying that this vegetable oil, in advertisement they will say cholesterol free oil. All the plant oils are free of cholesterol. Okay. So, they are fooling you by saying this. This oil is cholesterol free. Because cholesterol is a zoosterol. Clear? Cytosterol is a phytosterol. So, we take these cytosterol in our food. Okay. It is absorbed passively. Okay. But what happens? These absorbed fatty acid, that is this phytosterol, they will be excreted again actively. Okay. They will be actively. It is absorbed through Niemann pick like one. Okay. The cytosterol is absorbed through this protein, Niemann pick like protein. Okay. But they are exported through ABC transporters. The details we will again discuss this in lipoprotein metabolism. As of now, cytosterol is a phytosterol. Okay. See this. They are exported by this thing, ABC G5 and ABC G8. These are the ABC transporter. If there is any defect in this transporter, it will lead to cytosterolemia. Because what is happening? Through Niemann pick like protein, what is happening? This phytosterols are absorbed. Okay, but they are not excreted through this thing. Thus, we cannot contain phytosterol in our body. In normal amount, phytosterols are considered good. But in high amounts, these phytosterols are very bad. They increase the risk of atherosclerosis also. Okay, so in cytosterolemia, there is increased risk of atherosclerosis. That is why to inhibit this Niemann pick like protein, we give acetimib. Okay, acetimib is the treatment of cytosterolemia. Clear? See this, in cytosterolemia, you also can develop tuberous xanthomas. So, the answer is very simple, cytosterol. Okay, so with this, we conclude chemistry of lipids.